Hi, I'm Storm Tracker 18 meteorologist Jess Langlois. It's been a fairly snow-free March so far, but it is still March in Wisconsin, so snow isn't out of the question, and in fact, it is in the forecast for our Monday. Winter weather advisory for part of the area. It's just for Buffalo and Trempealeau counties, although snow is expected area-wide, but these areas, the areas shaded in purple, are expected to have the highest impacts from the system. Actually, the greatest impacts, even more than what we'll see locally, will be in parts of Minnesota and Iowa. The areas shaded in pink are under a winter storm warning. Those areas could see more than 6 inches of snow. But fortunately, the worst of it is a miss for us. But we're still expecting some snow, and that starts Monday. Fortunately, tonight we stay dry. Snow gradually starts to approach the area as we head into Monday and is on our doorstep, at least close to the Mississippi River, by about noontime tomorrow. And it's Monday afternoon when we'll see snow moving in across the area, starting around mid to late afternoon, Eau Claire area, and by Monday evening, the rest of us should be seeing some snow. The peak of it, especially for the Eau Claire area, looking like right around that evening commute time, around 5-6 o'clock tomorrow. And although we're not expecting a ton of accumulation, it's still enough that we could see some slippery road conditions through that evening commute. Snow gradually begins to wind down after midnight, going into Tuesday morning. A few light flurries possible through early Tuesday morning, but the bulk of it really will be between Monday afternoon and about midnight going into Tuesday. Clouds do linger into our Tuesday as well, so not expecting a ton of sunshine there. In terms of our totals, the highest amounts, again, those will be in Iowa and Minnesota. A pretty sharp cutoff in terms of totals as well as you get into our area. Most of us will be in the trace to 2-inch range, although the highest chance of seeing 2 inches would be further southwest, especially along and south of 94. Areas a little bit further north, probably on the lower end of that, but there's a good chance that most of us will see at least a half inch to around an inch. The highest totals, though, right along the border here into Buffalo, Trempealeau counties, also some higher totals possible in areas like Pepin County, anywhere between an inch up to about 4 inches on the high end, especially in those advisory areas. And then south of the border in Minnesota, those are the areas that totals really ramp up, and over 2 inches of snow is looking likely, up to about 6 inches, even potentially more than that. Thankfully, that's not in our area, though. This one's more of a miss to the south, but still looking at some accumulation and some slippery conditions as well. So as we go into tonight, we are looking at some cooler temperatures, increasing clouds. But for tomorrow, that's when we see that snow moving in. We're looking at afternoon snow showers, still a slight chance for some mixing with freezing rain, especially in that advisory area. So there could be some slippery areas on the roads as well from freezing rain on top of snow, but it's looking like snow will be the primary type of precipitation, again, that develops in the afternoon. Some lingering into early hours of Tuesday morning, but Tuesday is looking fairly dry. We're back in the 40s though by Tuesday, and then back in the 50s by St. Patrick's Day on Wednesday. So this winter weather is fairly short-lived, and we'll pretty much see most of that snow melt pretty quickly. We're back in that springtime feel, but just a brief interruption. Winter is coming back just for our Monday afternoon. Other than that though, precipitation chances minimal through the upcoming week.